It's good to be back in the house of the Lord this morning, and I'm glad to be among my brother and sisters that believe in the Lord and able to fellowship with them. I would like to say this morning that appreciate Brother Jared as he's come from time to time and filled in for me, and times I couldn't do a good job, and sometimes I don't even do a job. So, you know, it's I'm just asking that you remember me in prayer. We want to study some this morning in the book of John, John chapter 10, verse 1, concerning the shepherd and the good shepherd and the hireling. And we all know about these things, and that they go on all the time. The hireling is especially, people think that they've got something when they've got a hireling, and the hireling is no more than someone that's doing for what he can get out of it.
Right.
And so we'll try to study a few minutes here with this, and hope that you'll remember us as we try to study pray for us. In verse 1 of chapter 10, I am the good shepherd, is the title of it. He says,
amen.
Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that enters not by the door into the sheepfold, but climbeth up some other way, the same is a thief and a robber. And I've got a little note down here on this about the good shepherd and the door. And the door, according to the way I understand it, is always open. There's no one there that can close the door, but there's someone always there that can talk to the sheep and call the sheep out. And he says here, he that enters not by the door into the sheepfold, but climbeth up some other way, the same is as a thief and a robber. And this morning, we as God's people, we want to understand more about these things here, being a thief and a robber, because we sometimes think that we got what we think we have, but we hadn't got what we need. And so here he said in here, in verse 2, but he that enters in by the door is the shepherd of the sheep.
Amen.
And so this morning we want to talk to you about the shepherd of the sheep. And he says here in verse 3, to him the porter openeth. And I think they've got it called here the doorkeeper. The doorkeeper openeth, and the sheep hear his voice, and he calleth his own sheep by name, and leadeth them out. Now, I want you to understand this morning, people, if I can get anything across to you this morning, is that we, as God's people that have been saved, know the voice of the Lord.
That's right.
Now, you can say what you want to about all people thinking that he sounds pretty good, he talks a good talk, but listen, I know when I hear something that it's about, if it's of the Lord or not.
Amen.
And you and I all know this morning, that we have been saved, and listen, we are in tune with that voice. Mm-hmm. And when the Lord speaks to us, or when we hear spoke to from the Bible, and also we know it's the truth. Now, mm-hmm. there's so many people that have never heard this voice.
You're right.
And there's so many people this morning that will believe the harlot. Mm-hmm. And this is where the harlot comes in. And let me tell you something this morning. If it hadn't have been for the wolf, the harlot would have never been seen.
Right.
Because the wolf is the one that comes, and the harlot flees. And the wolf is always looking for the harlot to do what he can do, what damage he can do. And so he knows the harlot don't care anything about you and I. And so this is the wolf is on the prowl, the lion is on the prowl, the devil is always trying to disturb, he's trying
Amen.
To tear up and to mislead people. And so here in verse 3 he says, to him the porter openeth, and the sheep hear his voice, and he calleth his own sheep by name and leadeth them out. Now let
Amen.
Me tell you, this morning this fold that is in here, back in the days when this was written, and Jesus was talking about it, the fold had more than one group of sheep in it. Mm-hmm. And that's the same way it is today with the world. The world is as a fold, and it has many, many, many different folds in it. But the thing of it is, they're not all in tune with the Lord.
Amen.
And so this is should give us an encouragement this morning to, as even Brother Larry and him was out yesterday down at the festival, trying to get something out to someone and let them understand that there is a voice out there, there is a special thing out there for them, and they can't believe everything that comes along.
Amen.
And you know, we got so many different people in this world, and so many that wants to trick or wants to get monies or get earthly possessions by just making out like that they are trying to be a help to us, when listen, they're not a help. They're a hindrance to them. And he says here, the porter openeth, and the sheep hear his voice. And so this morning, I know that the devil has come in, mm-hmm. in different times and different places, and he's trying his best to take advantage of everyone that he can.
You're right.
But you and I need to keep our ears to the ground and listen. We ought to identify every time that we hear the Lord speaking to us, and also we ought to know when a false witness or a false prophet or anyone like that is talking to us, and steer away from it. Because listen, we do not need any of this mess of the of unknown tongues and all of these things.
Amen.
Coming into us and telling us that in other words, hell's an ice house and all this. Listen,
Amen.
We don't need these things.
Amen.
And we as God's people can stay so much farther, closer to him, if we will just listen to what the voice speaks to us. Now listen, in verse 4, and when he putteth forth his own sheep, he goeth before them. So this morning, when we are with the Lord, and when he is leading us, and he's always leading us, listen, we still need to keep our ears open and listen to that voice, because that is the true voice. And he's saying here, he put his own sheep before him, and the sheep follow him, for they know his voice. And this
Amen.
Morning, we as God's people, we need to understand that we are to follow that voice, and that we cannot let some imitator get in and lead us astray. Because hey, they're out there, they're out there all the time. And if they weren't, the Bible wouldn't have warned us about the harlot, and it wouldn't have warned us about the wolf and about what the wolf does to those people. Now later on down here, we'll see that the wolf catches them, but he don't kill them. He scatters them. And listen, that's this morning is what that the intent of the devil is to scatter the people.
Amen.
And let them go and make more people. Because listen, when he scatters those people and they hear his that and all that, listen, they turn completely over to this other voices, and they produce more of these people. So here he said here, and in verse 5 here, because of this, he says in verse 4, and when he putteth forth his sheep, he goeth before them, and the sheep follow him, and they know his voice, and a stranger will they not follow.
Amen.
But will flee from him, for they know not the voice of a stranger.
You're right.
And so this morning, you can blame who you want to, and I did it, and the devil made me do it, and all this. But listen, keep your nose above water, and you listen, and you pay attention to what's going on in your life this morning. Because listen, you're going through one time. You're going to have this experience one time.
Mm-hmm.
And people, if the Lord speaks to your heart, you listen to that, because listen, it ain't all over with until it's It's shouting time. So this morning, you take notice of this, what he's saying to you. So he said here in verse 6, this parable spake Jesus unto them, but they understood not what things they were which he spake to them. And it's that way. Mm-hmm. It's that way. You can, but the thing of it is, that shouldn't encourage you. That should, I mean, shouldn't discourage you, but it should encourage you. If someone don't hear what you're trying to say to them, and you see some kind of evidence of that, listen, you know that you've got one that has not heard the true voice. And you need to pray for that person. You need to try to be a witness for that person and tell them about the Lord Jesus Christ, because, listen, they're still in darkness and they're following a harlot or a harlot, and they're not following who they should. So here in verse 7, then said Jesus unto them again, verily, verily, or truly, truly, I say unto you, I am the door. In Amen. Other words, hey, that's the way. There's no other way, and he's the door, and if we don't go that way, that's the only way we can go.
Amen.
He said here, all that ever came before me are thieves and robbers, and he's talking about so many of the people that before him, because he says, and that even came before me, they were the false prophets. They were the Amen. Ones that was telling others, hey, that you can be baptized, you can be works, or you can worship a image or whatever. And so he says here, all that ever came before me are thieves and robbers. And they're the ones that will rob you. They're the ones that will mislead you. And so he says here, I am the door in verse 9. By me, if any man enter in, he shall be saved, and shall go in and out and find pasture.
Amen.
And so he has movement in the fold and go in and out and find pastures. And so that is one of our privileges this morning, is that, listen, we can come to the Lord, and sometimes we say, Lord, why can't we do this, or why can't I do this, or why, what's this, or what's this all about? But listen, you can ask, and listen, one day he'll tell you. He'll let you know what it's all about. It may not be when you say frog, he jumps. But listen, let me tell you something this morning. He has got a reason for everything that's going on in your life.
You're right.
And if he can help you with these things, he will. And listen, don't be discouraged. Don't be discouraged, because a lot of people they say, well, I'm not saved. I don't know if I'll ever be saved. But listen, it ain't over with.
Amen.
It ain't over with. And the thing of it is, this morning, just hang on and keep praying and keep trying to serve the Lord and listen. Just ask the Lord to watch over you and care for you and save you, because he's still in the saving business.
You're right.
And so here he said in verse 10, the thief cometh not but for to steal and to kill and to destroy.
Amen.
I am come that they might have life, and that they might have it more abundantly. So
there's
the two things. The thief comes to kill, and Jesus Christ came to this world, died on the cross for us, that we might have life. We might have it more abundantly. So he said, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd giveth his life for the sheep, and you know the servant paid the debt on the cross of Calvary
Amen.
For our sins. And he said here, but he that is a harlot and not the shepherd, whose own the sheep are not, seeth the wolf coming and leaveth the sheep and fleeth. And so it's the same way with that, and it's more so with that as in the realms of Christianity and all. People don't care anything about another person's soul.
You're right.
But they don't, because listen, there's nothing there for them to care for. If you're not a harlot, but if you're a good shepherd, listen, you have a desire to see men's souls saved.
And
you have a need. You have that desire to happen. So he says, but he that is a harlot and not a shepherd, whose own the sheep are not, seeth the wolf coming, and leaveth the sheep, and fleeth, and the wolf catches them, like I told you long ago, and scatters them.
You're right.
And so what is better than killing them? It's scattering them. And when it's just like grains of seed. What's the best, to take all the seed and put it in a bundle and put it in the water? Or if you want that seed, you scatter it. You scatter it out on the ground, it comes up. So this is what he's saying here. The devil just scatters it, or the wolf just scatters it. He don't care anything really about killing you right now, because, hey, he's where he at. And so take heed to this morning. But he says here in verse 13, the harlot fleeth because he is a harlot, mm-hmm. and careth not for the sheep. I am the good shepherd, Jesus Christ talking, and know my sheep, and am known of mine.
Amen.
As the Father knoweth me, even so know I the Father, and I lay down my life for my sheep.
Amen.
So we see here what a wonderful blessing it is this morning to know the good shepherd, because the good shepherd knows the Father, and they know one another.
Amen.
And listen, we're in their hand, they're in their hand, and we're safe. And and he says here, and other sheep I have, which are not of this fold.
Right.
And talking about the Gentiles, and he would come to them later. But here he says, therefore doth my Father love me, because I lay down my life that I might take it again. And
amen.
So this morning, it's in our corner, people. It's for us to look out and to search out and to study and to pray and to ask the Lord to lead us and to draw us closer unto Him, because that's the only place that we're safe. If we had a harlot, listen, we just wouldn't be saved.
Yeah.
He could preach hell, far, and damnation all he wanted to, but the thing of this, just as soon as something come in that would disturb him, he's gone.
Right.
And so this morning, therefore, in verse 17, therefore doth my Father love me, because I lay down my life that I might take it again. No man taketh it from me, but I lay it down for myself. I have power to lay it down, and I have power to take it again. This commandment have I received of my Father.
Amen.
So these things that Jesus is telling them, he received them from his Father. Therefore was a division among the Jews for these things, and many of them said, he has a devil. See, they couldn't identify the harlot. They identified Jesus Christ as the devil. But listen, they were wrong, and they're still wrong.
Amen.
And others said, these are not the words of him that had a devil. Can a devil open the eyes of the blind? So this will conclude our reading this morning. But if you look on over in the rest of the chapter, he says again, as he tells them, he says, my sheep hear my voice.
Amen.
My sheep, and you ought to keep that in your mind. My sheep hear my voice.
You're right.
And they will listen to another. And so take heed to what you've got and build on that. But do not listen to these harlots. Do not listen to these false prophets. Do not think about the Lord Jesus Christ not loving you and caring for you, because, listen, he gave his life for you.
Amen.
And so thank you so much for listening to what little I read, what little I had to say, but I hope it'll be a blessing to you in some way to do this and hear this. And so we thank you for your attention. Thank you so much.
Amen.